Hello friends, I am Mr. G.V. Pujari, working as an assistant professor in Sharon-Stop Technology College of Engineering. So welcome back in lecture of machine drawings. So we are learning since last 2-3 lectures about sectional views. We have learned in our last lecture about the full section, half section, partial section, offset section. Also, we have learned about the revolved section. In today's lecture, we are going to see about the removed section. So here, now we are going to see in today's lecture onwards is in removed section. Removed section and revolved sections are very close to each other. Here what we are doing in removed section, the views are continued removed. Section A removed section is a section or partial section not directly projected from the view containing the cutting plane and not revolved or turned from its normal orientation. So in removed section what we are doing here, as the same example we have seen in revolved section also. So this is a bar, hexagonal bar. You want to see how it looks from inside, because whenever we are taking a front view, that time it looks only a one rectangle. Okay, so we want to see from inside. So that for that purpose we are going to take here a sectional view, or we are taking here a cutting plane. Okay, and after cut of this section you will look like this hexagonal shape here. As like in revolved section what we are doing, we are going to turn this same view 90 degree, and we are going to superimpose on the same view. Okay, what we are going to do, we are going to superimpose this view on front or top view where you want to place this revolved section. Like here also you will see, here we have in revolved section we have taken here cut, and then we have turned this into 90 degree, and we are placing it into this view, and this is a revolved section. Like same thing we are going to do in a removed section. What we are going to do, this is our bar, we have taken cut here, but instead of superimposing this hexagonal view here, we will keep this hexagon at separate side or keep aside, so that will not be mixed with your view. So this is only different in between revolved section and removed section. So all both are same, but in revolved section just we are turning 90 degree of that whatever the view or whatever the section you want to show, and we are going to superimpose on that front view. But here what we are going to do, just we are going to keep away from this view. Okay, so this is a remote section. We will see one more example here. So we are going to compare the problem is same, just we are going to compare with revolved section and remote section. Okay, here see, as earlier also in revolved section we have seen this problem. Here this is hexagonal shape, and here this is a circular shape of bar. Okay, it is one bar having different kind of cross section. One cross section is a hexagonal and one cross section is circular. So we have taken here a cutting plane, cut here, and then we have taken a turn 90 degree these views both. And when you take turn 90 degree of this view, then we are going to superimpose this on the same front view. Again we are going to superimpose this view on here. Okay, so this is a revolved section. A removed section is only the same thing, we are going to show sectional view of same thing, but only thing we are going to do, just we are going to keep that sectional view apart from that same view. We are not going to overlap on the view. Okay, here also we have done, we have overlapped. Okay, we have kept this on previous view. of this whatever cut section we have done. And here what we have done, here we have kept aside of this view, whatever you have taken here, hexagonal view, and whatever we have taken here, this circular cut section, just we are keeping aside. So this is hexagonal and this is circular. So this is called removed section. So removed section means remove aside. Okay, so in itself in the name, that will tell you, removed section means we are going to keep away. Okay, so this is one example. So one more example we are going to see here, with compare with revolved and removed section. This is one object and we have taken here a cutting plane, and you want to see how it looks here. Okay, so when you take a cut here, this sectional plane here, then we turn this 90 degree here and we'll keep as it is here. Okay, whatever the sectional view is present inside, just turn 90 degree and we have kept as it is here. So this is your revolved section. And removed section is only different thing is what, whatever the view we have generated here, we will keep aside. Okay, we are not going to superimpose this view on our front view or top view anywhere. Okay, just we'll keep aside. So this is our removed section. So in revolved section, this whatever our sectional view may be superimposed on this, it may be mixed with this our view, but it is very easy to understand. The removed section can be easily identified because we are keeping aside of this view. Then next, one more example. This is a top view and this is a front view of our problem. Okay, then we want to understand how it looks inside here, and that will not be able to see from outside how it is a sectional view inside. So you will take here one cutting plane. Okay, we have taken here one cut and this is a direction of view. We'll remove this side one and you will get here this view. Okay, and just we'll keep aside. This is called a sectional view. So this is called a removed section view. Then one more, just have placed here 3D image, so it will help you to understand properly. Same image, this is a top view and this is a front view. Okay, and we want to understand this one. You have taken here cutting plane. Here also we have taken cutting plane. This is AA and this is also A. Okay, so this is a cutting plane. So we have cut here, and after cut we want to see how it looks from inside. So we are not going to put here. So when you see from inside, it looks like this one. Okay, from inside it looks like this shape. So this is a sectional view. From when you see from this side, the direction, see here, this is a section just here shown, and that section we are going to show, or that section we are going to keep at a side, so that this is we have kept at side. Okay, so this is a sectional view, and you can understand by, because it is kept aside. Okay, it is not mixed with your like revolved view. Okay, so removed section is very easy to understand. So one more example is here. This can be, you can able to understand very easily. This is our object. We have taken, we want to see from how it looks inside. Okay, so we are going to take cut here by one cutting plane. When we cut this object, we'll keep aside two object, because whatever this side, this object will going to remove side. Then we will see it looks like this star. This look like a star inside. Okay, so this is a sectional view you want to draw. If we want to draw in a revolved section, how we are going to draw? So see, this is a revolved section. just we are going to turn 90 degree here and we will place here and superimpose on this our front view. We are going to superimpose on our front view here. This is a revolved section, but we want to see a removed section. Just whatever this turn view we have superimposed on this front view, we will keep aside. Okay, we are going to keep aside. This is we have kept aside. So this is very easy thing, and just we are drawing away from our front view. So it is does not require to mix with our front view. So this is called a removed section view. Okay, so very easy to understand. Now we have learned about the removed section. Now we are going to see about the auxiliary view. So what is mean by auxiliary view? First of all, we will see the definition about the auxiliary view. An auxiliary view is an orthographic view taken in such a manner that the lines of sight are not parallel to the principal projection plane, frontal, horizontal or profile. There are an infinite number of possible auxiliary views of any given object. So this is a theory. Now we are going to see about the actual what is mean by this. Now see, this is one example. When you draw this front view, it will going to draw from this side. When you draw right side view, you are going to draw from this side. When you are going to draw top view, you are going to draw from this side. But it is very difficult to understand actual view of this portion, because you will not be get actual dimension or actual look of this portion in any one view. You will not be able to see this in a front view. This actual dimension will not be able to see in a right side view, will not be able to see in a top view. Okay, so it is difficult to imagine how it looks from this side. So for this purpose, we are going to take a auxiliary view. So like this, we are going to project this on a imaginary plane, auxiliary plane, and then we are going to draw this view. So this is called a auxiliary view, so that we can understand how this plane can be looks. Okay, does not require to imagine. Just we are going to take an imaginary plane, and on that we are going to draw this auxiliary view. See, we are going to take one example here of auxiliary section. So this is one problem. This is a front side and this is a side view. Front view and side view of this one problem, but will not be able to see how it looks from this side. Okay, so how we are going to draw and imagine how it looks from inside? We are going to take one sectional view, or when we are going to take one cut here. Okay, and whatever the views are present here, that will we are going to draw here. Okay, so this is called auxiliary sectional view. So whatever we are not able to imagine how it looks here, and that we are going to keep aside. This is our auxiliary sectional view. One more example I am going to show you here. Front view, side view, and this is the top view. This is a manifold throttle. Material is the aluminium. Now how it looks from this side, it is very difficult to understand. So that's why we are going to take one auxiliary plane here, cutting plane here, and how it looks from inside, that we are going to draw on that auxiliary plane. So this is called auxiliary section, and that we are going to draw on auxiliary plane. Okay, so just auxiliary section is nothing but we want to imagine how the parts that that will not be come into front view, that will not be come into side view, that will not be come into top view. It is difficult to draw view, true view. Actually, we are going to say like this, it is true view. We will not be able to draw true view in a front view, side view or top view. That we are going to take your auxiliary plane and that we are going to draw a side. This is called a auxiliary view. Now, we are going to see one more view here. So this is two steps, and when you take this front view, you will get this side. When you will take a right side view, you will get this side. But here, these are the steps. Here also, this is a step. Okay. That will not be get in any kind of view. That will not be get in a front view, side view, or top view. And that portion we can be able to only draw in auxiliary section view. So you will see here, we have taken here one cutting plane. We have taken here one cutting plane, and on this cutting plane, whatever the points are present here, we are going to project here. That points we are going to project on this auxiliary section view. Okay, and then you will get actual true value or true dimension of this one. Okay, so in today's lecture only we have learned about the whatever mean by removed section and what is the difference between revolved section and removed section, and also we have learned about the auxiliary section. Thank you very much for listening carefully this lecture. In coming lectures again we are going to see about the whatever remaining thing about this sectional view. Thank you very much.